Hello, let's do some math for fun. This question is from Brilliant. We are going to find the real solution to the cubic equation x plus the power minus 3x squared minus 3x minus 1 is equal to 0. How can we solve a cubic equation like this? Maybe the cubic formula by Cardano? I don't know, but as always, please pause the video and try this first. And yes, Xiaotutu is watching us. She wants to learn as well. Alright, if you did use the cubic formula, leave a comment down below, let us know. I will actually show you guys two ways to do it. The first way is by the brilliant user. The name is Drop the Problem, which is so cool. And secondly, I will also show you guys a cubic formula, but not by Cardano. It's actually by Lagrange. Lagrange is so something, yeah. By the way, so I'm just going to do this right here for you guys. Here we go. Notice this right here, it's almost like x plus 1 to the third power, but not quite, because we have all the negatives right here. It's okay, let me just bring this to the other side. So we get x to the third power, that's equal to 3x squared plus 3x plus 1, yep. Great, but we do not have x to the third power here. It's okay, I'm just going to add x to the third power on both sides, and you see, this right here is just nicely 2x to the third power, and this right here, we get x plus 1 to the third power. And this is actually very nice, because after we take the cube on both sides, this becomes just a linear situation. The left-hand side, we just get the cube root of 2 times x. And the right-hand side, this and that, will of course, will cancel. And we just get x plus 1. And this right here, we can just minus the x on both sides and then divide 3 square root of x minus 1 on both sides. So you'll see, this is just going to be x equals, and we get 1 over 3 square root of 2. Again, minus the x, so it's minus 1 right here. And we are done. But let me also ask you guys a small question. How would you rationalize the denominator right here? We have a cube root. Well, we can still multiply by the conjugate, but the conjugate here is much more crazier than the square root situation. What we will do is, we will multiply the top and bottom by this square, so I'll just put down cube root of 4, and then we add this times that, which is just a cube root of 2, and then we have to add this square, so it's just plus 1, like this. Of course, do the same thing on the top as well, and this is just the what? Difference of 2 cube formula, right? In the end, we end up with x equals, on the bottom, when you multiply this out, you just need to do this to the third power, which is 2, and then minus this to the third power, which is 1, 2 minus 1, which is just 1 on the bottom, and the top is just this times that, so we just have this on the top. Namely, cube root of 4 plus the cube root of 2, and if you would like, you can also write this as the cube root of 1, just to be cool, but let me just keep it as 1. Anyway, this right here is it, which is very, very cool. We just complete the cube. Very good, right? Alright, here's the second way, and maybe some of you guys have not seen this before. Me neither. I found this on Brilliant. This right here is the Lagrange's resolved. Notice that this is not the cubic formula by Cardano, right? We start with this cubic equation, and we'll change it into this quadratic equation. And of course, we can solve this, and we'll call the solutions to be Z1 and Z2. In the end, we just have to put them right here, and we can get the x value. That's it. In this video, I'm not going to show you guys how to go from here to here, or from here to here. I will just demonstrate that it works with the equation that we are working on. So have a look. Well, in this question here, a is negative 3, b is negative 3, and c is equal to negative 1. I will just change that right here. So we have c squared plus parentheses, we have 2a, a is negative 3, right, and then to the third power, and then minus 9 times ab, which are both negative 3. And then we have to add 27 times c is negative 1, and then don't forget we have to multiply by z. And then we have this, plus parentheses, a is negative 3, and we have that square, minus 3 times b, which is negative 3, and then raised to a third power, and that's equal to 0. So this is what they call the resolvent equation. Notice this is just quadratic. The numbers are pretty big. Well, it's okay, it's quadratic, so we can solve it with a quadratic formula, right? So now I will just put the things that we need in here. You will see that x is equal to negative a, which is negative 3 right here. And then let me just add the cube root of z1. I'll put down that's 54. Lastly, we can add cube root of 108 and then all divided by 3. Now, if we simplify this, you know this is the same as 27 times 2. So you can factor out a 3, right? And then this right here is 27 times 4. And again, you can factor out the 3. So you can divide out the 3. In the end, x is nicely equal to, well, let me just put it down. This is 1 plus, again, we will just get the cube root of 2. And then the cube root of 4. Of course, this is the same answer like we got earlier. Man, isn't this so cool, right? Both methods are so cool, and maybe in the future, I will show you guys how to derive this right here. If you want to learn more, you can head to Brilliant and check out more of their awesome courses. Especially, many people are on the lookout for online math resources right now, and whether you are a student looking to get ahead, a professional brushing up on cutting-edge topics, or someone who just wants to use this time to understand the world better, then definitely check them out. Try adding some learning structure to your day by setting a goal to improve yourself, and then work at that goal just a little bit every day. Brilliant makes that possible with interactive explorations and a mobile app. Now you can actually take it with you wherever you go. And if you want to build up your problem-solving skills or enhance your analytical abilities, or maybe just want to impress your friends, then you can get their premium subscription to learn something new. Brilliant Stop Provoking Math courses can help you to mastery by taking complex topics and breaking them down to small sizes, and you can understand them better that way. You will start by having fun with their interactive courses, and over time, you will be amazed how much you can accomplish. So head to brilliant.org/blackpenredpen. That way we can get 20% off discount to the annual premium subscription. Thanks so much for checking them out, and thanks to Brilliant for sponsoring this video. And as always, that's it.